Firstly, thank you for this invitation to participate in these seminars. It's a pleasure to participate and show some of my work. I would like to start with the presentation of LAQB, where I work, Associated Laboratory for Green Chemistry, Clean Technologies and Profess, is the largest network in chemistry and chemical engineering in Portugal, with different centers in all Portugal, and with several fields, and our group work in biochemical process engineering in the Nova School of Science and Technology, Campus Caparica, in Nova University of Lisbon. In this presentation, I'm going to introduce some work related to CAT4F gas project that is related to the environmental mitigation of fluorinated gases using key enabling technologies. The goal of this project is to design and validate different key enabling technologies for the separation and recovery of fluorinated gases used in refrigeration and air conditioner equipment. This project was coordinated by us, Nova School of Science and Technologies, in collaboration with different academic institutions from Spain and France, different industrial partners, and other stakeholders, for example, European platforms, Environmental Federation, NGO, public administration, and different foundations. And nowadays, there are a clear problem related to the climate change. And in this problem is related, is a clear related with the concentration of greenhouse gases emissions. And the human activities has a clear effect in this important problem. In this slide, you can see different news of the last summer in Europe, okay, with the clear effects of the global warming, for example, heavy rainfalls, floods, wildfires, and a clear increment of the temperature in all countries. The concentration of fluorinated gases is small in comparison with the other greenhouse gases. However, the global warming effect of these compounds is up to 23,000 higher than carbon dioxide, and their atmosphere lifetime is up to 50,000 years in the atmosphere. Then the effect of these compounds is clear and worrying. Furthermore, the hydrofluorocarbon emissions in Europe increased clearly in the last years in comparison with the other greenhouse gases that decreased in the last years. And this quantification only identified direct emissions, not indirect emissions related to the consumption of energy or the emissions related to the parallel economy. That is a very important problem in Europe. The parallel economy is related to the illegal market. And in the last years in Europe, there are a lot of examples of the use of illegal refrigerants in Europe, and the emissions of these compounds are not quantified in an official page and reports, okay? Furthermore, taking into account the increment of the temperature, okay, in all countries, the prediction show a clear increment of the use of fluorinated compounds, gases, fluorinated gases, because the use of refrigerants equipment and cooling equipment in the next, in the coming years is clear due to related to the increment of the temperature. Taking into account this problem, there are a strong legislation related in order to control the emissions of these compounds. This legislation starts with the Montreal Protocol with for all greenhouse gases, the Kyoto Protocol, and in the last years, there are specific legislation in Europe and at an international level, the Kigali Agreement, for these specific greenhouse gases, fluorinated gases, okay? With the specific legislation in, this is one example in Portugal, okay, of the application of European legislation at a national level, with clear goals for the 2030 and 25, okay? Then the industry need to solve and to reuse these compounds in the coming years. And the fluorinated, hydrofluorocarbon gases was the, were the good, the perfect solutions for the ozone depletion in the Montreal Protocol, because these compounds are non-toxic and non-flammable, but with the use and with the time, we identify other important problems. These fluorinated gases have a high global warming potential. A refrigerant is a fluid that absorbs heat at low temperature and low pressure and transfers heat at high temperature and high pressure. And the perfect refrigerants must have the following properties: not flammable, good stability, low toxicity, and non-corrosive. However, there are an important problem because all refrigerants, a lot of refrigerants contain some of these compounds, chlorine, fluorine or hydrogen. And when you increase the concentration of these elements, you increase important problems, the flammability, the toxicity, or the global warming potential, or atmospheric lifetime. Then the mixture is a good solution in order to minimize these important problems. Taking into account the strong legislation and these problems, okay, the European market is evolving in the direction of the new generation of the refrigerants, the quarter generation, that is in a lot of case mixtures with low global warming potential and low ozone depletion potential. Other important problem in the refrigeration sector is it depends on the linear economy. All production is submitted for incineration that contribute to the climate change also, okay? In our project, we apply a circular economy in order to recover and reuse the compounds in the in of the life of a cycler life, to reuse these compounds in the production of new refrigerants of quarter generation. Then the first step was to identify the refrigerants most used in the European market, okay? And with pure fluorinated gases that contain these current refrigerants of third generation with high global warming potential, with pure fluorinated gases that can use in the new refrigerants of quarter generation with low global warming potential. This new generation use these compounds because the concentration is small and in order to increase the efficiency of these refrigerants. However, the global warming potential is smaller. Then in our project, we recycle and separate pure fluorinated gases used in refrigerants of third generation with high global warming potential in order to reuse these pure compounds in the production of the new refrigerants of quarter generation with low global warming potential. And there are some examples in this slide. Okay, then we need to select and to identify the most efficient technologies to separate these compounds from different key enabling technologies based on advanced materials, nanotechnology, and advanced process, okay? In order to select the most efficient separation process for these compounds. In our group, we study different advanced materials for the separation of these compounds. Pure fluorinated ionic liquids, deutetic solvents, composites, and porous solid matrix. Okay? Why we use fluorinated ionic liquids? Because these compounds can be combined the unique and exceptional properties of two important families, perfluorocarbons and ionic liquids. Then we can obtain compounds with low surface tension that are inert with high surfactant power and low vapor pressure. When we incorporate fluorinated alkyl chains in ionic liquids, we can control the formation of a new nanosegregation domain, the fluorinated domain. Then we can obtain ionic liquids with three different nanosegregate domains, polar, hydrogenated, and fluorinated nano domains with completely different properties, okay? Then ionic liquids can be considered three-in-one solvents, increasing the surfactant behavior, the tuneability capacity, and the solubility power of traditional ionic liquids. In this project, we studied different fluorinated ionic liquids in order to study the influence of the cation, of the fluorinated chains, in the functional group, and the anion, in the solubility of the difference of the three pure fluorinated gases study in this project in different ionic liquids. In these figures, you can see the solubilities where the full symbols are the desorption process and the empty symbols are the desorption process. There is not hysteresis in this solubility process and absorption process. Okay, and in these fluorinated ionic liquids, the best solubilities of fluorinated gases were for the ionic liquids based on perfluorobutane sulfonate anion. And then we can calculate the selectivity for the different binary mixtures of the fluorinated gases. And for the first separation and the last separation, the best candidates were ionic-liquid based in a small small anions. However, for this separation, ionic liquid based in perfluorobutano sulfonate anions has the best separations. In the experimental, at least this experimental information has been modeled using a soft-SAF equation in collaboration with Lourdes Vega. Okay. Soft-SAF equation is a modification of the original SAF, and this model allow building models for fluorinated ionic liquids with high predictive capabilities for other systems, and with molecular parameters can be transferred for different families of ionic liquids. And in this paper, you can see the very good results of this model for the prediction of the behavior of these complex systems based on fluorinated ionic liquids. And the phase behavior between fluorinated gases and fluorinated ionic liquids can be reproduced satisfactorily using this model. And this model can be used to predict other systems that still is not determined experimentally. Other advanced material that we study in our project was the eutectic solvents. That is a good alternative to ionic liquids because these compounds are easy to obtain, are less expensive than ionic liquids, and can have a similar physical properties and phase behavior to ionic liquids. The first step was to have a screening between the different ionic liquids and with different acids in order to identify that what mixtures can be formed the eutectic solvents and in what proportions. And in some case, the eutectic solvents is not the best solutions in comparison with fluorinated ionic liquids, because this last, the fluorinated ionic liquids, has a better performance. However, when we use the eutectic solvents based on fluorinated ionic liquids with the same acids, the performance increase, okay? And the higher solubilities is obtained for the eutectic solvents based in ammonium cation with the carboxylate acid, okay? And these, the eutectic solvents, has a good selectivity for the separation of this fluorinated gases, improving the separation power of fluorinated ionic liquids. Then is a good solutions for these separations. These systems can be also modeled using SAF equation. This work was carried out in collaboration with Felix Jobel, and SAF can be reproduced satisfactorily the phase behavior of these systems, and can be used to the prediction of a new systems. Other advanced materials studying our project was composites based in the mixture of silica with different ionic liquids. And in this table, you can see the different mixture studied in this work. And this figure show the absorption capacity of these advanced materials. And for the small gases, R32, the best results was for the ionic liquids based in small anions. And however, for the higher fluorinated gases, the perfluorobutano anion is the best solutions or candidate for this separation. And the last advanced material that we studied in our project was a porous solid matrix, activated carbon, zeolites, and metal organic frameworks. And the performance of these materials is higher than the previous advanced materials. The absorption capacity of these materials is very high. And the best results was obtained for the R32. In this project, we study four metal organic frameworks and 9 activated carbons in order to study the performance of these compounds. And the best selectivities was for the separation of 32 with R125 was with activated carbons, improving the separation power of fluorinated ionic liquids, diathetic solvents, and composites. Then the next step in our project was to build the prototypes for the separation of these fluorinated gases. In this project, we developed 2 prototypes based on 2 different advanced separation processes, based on absorption technology and membrane technology, with low energy requirements, long lifetime, and high separation performance for these fluorinated gases. And these prototypes was validated using the most used commercial refrigerants in Europe in air conditioner equipment, R410A, that is a binary mixture of the pure fluorinated gases R32 and R125, okay? In order to recover the R32 for the reutilization in the new generation of the quarter of the new quarter generation of refrigerants with low global warming potential. In our group, we validate the prototype based on absorption technology that was building in this project. This absorption prototype was validated taking into account a dual target with 2 different purities of R32, taking into account the international standard for the reclamation of these refrigerants. Okay. In this figure, you can see the molar fraction of R32 and the molar fraction of R125 as a function of the time operation for the separation of these commercial refrigerants using an activated carbon packet column, okay? For optimization of the separation process of these commercial refrigerants, we study two different possibilities, operation cycles, one conventional batch process and one semi-continuous operation cycle. Okay, well, there are two steps, okay? In the conventional batch process, the optimization, the best results for two different experiments were obtained for two different operation times that you can see in this part, that obtain the two purities that we want, taking into account the international standard, okay, for the separation of these commercial refrigerants. In order to increase the recovery of the previous process, we implement a semi-continuous operation cycle, where we use the recycling stream from the first batch operation process with that is a mixture of 40% of R32 and 70% of R125 after the separation of nitrogen. We use this recycling stream to feed again in the absorption unit during this time in order to increase the recovery of R32 with the same purity. Then, with this semi-continuous separation process, we can obtain an 80% of the recovery, and with the recovery of the R32 from this from the commercial refrigerants with a high purity, okay, 99.5%. This is a very good result, taking into account that is a very simple separation process, okay? This technology was validated taking into account the environmental, the cost, and the social point of the view. And this technology answered the European legislation in order to reuse to apply a circular economy and reuse fluorinated gases in the production of the new generation of refrigerants with low global warming potential. And these technologies have a clear environment benefits because these technologies are up to 70% greener than the current alternatives, and more than the 95% better in terms of ozone depression. The design of the operation units of these technologies doesn't require expensive equipment, and all materials have a low cost. And the operational cost of these technologies are in the range of the 32 euros per kilo of R32. That is very competitive price in comparison with the commercial price of the refrigerants, R32. These technologies are totally clean and can be used with a small modification for other mixtures. So for example, R404A and R407C that are other examples of commercial refrigerants very used nowadays in the refrigerants equipment. This project apply research and eco innovation in order to protect the environment and to increase the competitiveness of industry. And in this project, we obtain very important products, publications, prototypes, and one software. Okay. In this project, we had a lot of sensibilization campaigns and good practice transfers for the different stakeholders of the developed technologies, with several meetings and visit with the industry and waste managers, and a lot of workshops and events with a lot of participants in these workshops and events. And we have a lot of articles in press and in media, and several papers and communication in Congress. And this show the impact of this European project. With these meetings, visits, workshops, and events with the different stakeholders, we can solve different problems of these stakeholders: companies, industry, public administration, waste management, managers, and researchers. Okay. The two principal products of this project was, for one part, the prototypes that we described before, and the second product was a software that allow us to select key enabling technologies. This software or tool allow us the classification of all waste that contain fluorinated gases according to the European methods, allow to understand the impact of fluorinated gases, and allow to select the best solutions available for the fluorinated gases treatment. In this slide, you can see the first part of the software or tool, where you can classify the different ways that contain fluorinated gases. In the second part of the software, you have all commercial refrigerants available in the market and the corresponding composition, with the global warming impact of these refrigerants, and with the corresponding impact to the climate change. And this part is very important in order to evaluate the contribution to global warming. And in the last part of the software, you can select the different key enabling technologies, okay, for the treatment of
for example, of
the in order to identify the opportunities to apply proposals. We also prepare different innovation facets in order to explain the different products of our project, the prototypes, the software, and the different documents for the good practice. And we also prepare different videos about the prototypes for the fluorinated gases separation, a sensibilization video for children, for stakeholders, and for the general public in order to explain clearly this important problem, okay? And finally, two different videos for the capitalization of the results of this project. All this information is available free of the charge in our web page. In summary, in our project, we applied eco-innovation technologies to increase the environmental mitigation of fluorinated gases, increase the technology transfer and the sensibilization of this important problem related to climate change. In this, the cut for fluor gas has finished the last September. And in October of the October, in the last October, we start other European projects, like for F gases, where we are going to apply these technologies in a real environment, in one of the most important waste manager companies in Portugal, Ambi Group, where we are going to validate and implement this technology in a real environment. I would like to thank the financial support from the Interreg Sudo program and LIFE program for these projects, and the co-workers, the co-authors of these results that today I present in this presentation. I finish my presentation. Thank you all for your attention.
Professor Ana Pereiro, thank you so much for the presentation. We are now open to questions. If you want to ask one, please enable your microphone or write it down at the chat and we will read it. Also, our YouTube viewers can write it down, of course. Professor Fred, your microphone is unable.
Yeah. Can I start? Anna, yeah. Thank you for the presentation. It's a lot of information, so I was completely lost in this amount of data that you put in our presentation. I wonder about the adsorption, separation adsorption. You separate 32 from 135, but it's always a kind of test, or you are going to use as a separate product. It's not clear to me.
In the first part of the project, we validate only the thermodynamic behavior, the adsorption process. But in the last part of the project, it was implemented and building prototypes for the separation, okay, of these of the commercial refrigerants. We use the most used commercial refrigerants in air conditioner equipment are 420A. That is a binary mixture of R32 and R125, okay? And we apply a clear separation process, okay, for these commercial refrigerants. And we obtain the separation of R32 with a high purity and high recovery. And in the second, in this new European project, we are going to increase the TRL, okay? And we are going to apply these technologies in the Portuguese industry.
Okay, and it was necessary only one column for this separation, or
yes, in the cat for fluor gas we use only one column, but in the life for FA gas we are going to use two columns in order to increase the recovery, okay, of these compounds with different separation cycles.
And what kind of that option did you use for this?
Depending, in this presentation there are a lot of information. Is an overview of our project, of course, but we use in this column activated carbon, but the specific details is in this moment under study, okay.
Thank you, Anna.
Thank you, Fred.
Professor Ed Magid, can I ask Ed?
Hi, Anna. That was a really amazing talk with lots and lots of data. I had a couple questions about the experimental methods. When you measure the absorption isotherms, is this with a gravimetric or a volumetric technique?
We use both, okay, depending of the advanced materials. In some cases, we use the most used in our group is the gravimetric method, okay? But in some cases, depending of the availability of the equipment, we use a volumetric method for the measures.
Okay, and so then I wondered, when you have the deep eutectic solvents, do they have any measurable vapor pressure? Do you have any problems with them? I imagine the ionic liquids are totally non-volatile, but are the deep eutectics are also very much non-volatile?
In my binary mixtures, okay, in my deutetic solvents, we don't have any problem with the vapor pressure, but this is for this specific deutetic solvents, of course.
Okay. And have you just done single component gas measurements, or are you able to do mixed gas measurements? I wonder about the non-ideality in the liquid phase. Do you think these are just going to be ideal behaving?
Depending of the systems, there are systems that have near ideal behavior, but other the deviation is high, depending of the interaction and the specific systems, of course.
Great.
I know all collaboration of Edward McGinnis with Schiffler with these systems, and there are different examples depending of the systems.
Great. Thank you very much. Nice work.
Mm-hmm. Professor Anna, we also have one question from Professor Richard at the chat, so I'm gonna ask the question. So what year was this project started? Go ahead, then I ask the second one.
I can share my presentation.
Sorry, he is here with us. So he also can ask themselves, I don't know.
This, the gap for F gas start in 2018, okay? And we finished this project the last September, but now we start this other European project, okay?
Okay, the second one is, when was the first proposal written?
Maria, Richard is here, so he can...
Okay, let's wait for him to enable the microphone and ask himself the question.
Thanks.
Go ahead, Professor Richard.
Hi.
Hi, Richard.
Thanks for that. Yeah, I just was curious. I guess it shows there on the slide that you started in 2018, but that it seemed like so impressive how much work you got done in only three years.
No, but there are a lot of in this presentation we are present my the experimental data carried out in our group, but the prototypes and the bits, workshops and meetings were carried out for all partnerships, all partners, and there are a lot of partners that participate in this project, of course.
Oh, okay. So when did that first the overall project begin?
Yes, the experimental data in this presentation is only carried out in our project, in our group, okay? But the sensibilization campaigns, the documents for the technology transfer, the workshops, the visits to industry, the numbers is for all projects, for all partners, okay?
Yeah, I understand that, but I'm just wondering how many years have evolved, elapsed?
Three years and a half, okay? Years, yes. Oh, a lot of work and the COVID problems in the middle.
Okay, wow. Very amazing.
Yeah.
Then I was wondering about that 32 euros for the recovery. That's not including the collection of the refrigerants from wherever they're at, often some air conditioner in a house in Lisbon, and then getting it from there into this treatment facility, right?
There are different costs associated for the treatment of these gases. The companies we need to pay duties related with the treatment of these gases, and in our group didn't do the cost analysis. This carried out with other partners, but I think that they considered this cost in the in the final price, I think, but I need to check the details of course, but I think that the partner considered this cost in because this 32 euros is per kilo of the R32.
So last question. So what is their suggestion then, or what's the policy going forward to, you know, to recover that cost? Are they going to put that $32 as a tax when it's first sold this refrigerant? They put that in the
in Europe, of course, there are an important problem in the companies and in the industry, because normally all fluorinated gases are mixture for the same deposit, okay? And this is very complicated in order to apply, okay, these technologies in a waste manager. But in this new European project, we are going to collaborate with a waste manager in order to implement a selectivity recovery of these gases, okay, from the equipments, in order to facilitate the implementation of the separation process in the industry. Because it's very important in order to obtain, because this cost, 32 euros, is for the separation from the from one binary mixture. If you complicate with more compounds, okay, and with more commercial refrigerants, this initial mixture, the price of course increase, okay, and we need a selective collecting of these refrigerants in order to have a competitive price, of course.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, any more questions from the audience? I don't, there is one question here. It is from Professor Hugen Langin. Professor, if you wanna enable your microphone, please feel free to ask your question. Otherwise I can ask.
I can check the I can share my presentation because I in order to the global warming potential of the quarter generation of the refrigerants, in this slide, you can see one moment. Okay, in this slide, you can compare the global warming potential of the third generation of the refrigerants, okay, with examples of different commercial refrigerants, and the global warming potential of the new generation, okay, with low global warming potential, okay. And in the other question related to the activated carbons, the absorption is related to the porous matrix that increase the interaction and increase the surface contact between the fluorinated gas and the advanced materials, and this favorate the absorption capacity of these compounds. And also the separation for these compounds is higher. This is the two questions that the Professor Jürgen Lenz put in the chat, Maria.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for answering the question. So our time is almost over. I wanna thank everyone for the discussion. And once again, thank you, Professor Ana Pereiro, for the presentation.